Hi guys and welcome back. In this two-part video, I'll be talking about my process over a time-lapse recording. This is the second part of which the previous video showed my sketching and inking stages. But in this video, we will look at my colouring techniques. So I begin by creating a colour palette. I find it easier to create the colour palette beforehand, therefore I'm not trying to find the colours later on. Right now, I'm just blocking in the base tone for the skin. I'm not too worried about being a little bit messy here. At this point, I start clearing up the edges. I want to turn this layer into a clipping mask to help my blending later on. Right now I'm creating another layer and another swatch for the eyes. Putting in some smaller details in. Now I'm creating the swatches for the hair. Blocking in the base tone for the hair now. Just clearing up the outside edges. The idea behind creating a clipping mask is that when I'm adding other colours onto the layer, the original layer, which will be this one, the base tone, will create a clipping mask. So whenever I brush colours over, it won't go over the lines, it will stay only where there's colour on the previous layer. You can think of it almost like a lasso tool that focuses only on the previous layer and whatever's been coloured in. There you go, just creating the mask now for the skin. And now I'm adding in the shading and the highlights. Blocking in the colours right now. I'll blend them in later. Notice how I can go straight over the hair, but I'm not actually painting on the hair. That's also to do with the fact that it's a layer below, but also I can't go over the edges. it's really easy to look at this stage and go, it doesn't look very good. But when it's finally blended together, it's like applying makeup. You gotta have those really awkward contour lines that are really sharp, and then you blend it all together. Creating a clipping mask for the hair now. Now the hair that I've got that appears behind the neck, I've just done in a basic lower, darker colour. Because it's supposed to be permanently shadow. Now creating the actual shadows and the highlights. You'll notice I have a navigator window near the top right. I use that to see the larger picture when I'm more focused up. It gives you the ability to almost take a step back and look at the picture from a distance without actually having to physically step back or squint. Now moving on to the blending layers, and I've realised that the best way to blend it is to merge layers together. Working on the skin first. I'm just clearing up where I've smudged over the edges. Now blending in with the eyes. And now moving on to the hair. Now with the hair, when it comes to blending, it's important to go along with the hair grain. It's not that skin, you don't want like a super smooth surface like the skin. Clearing out the edges where I've smudged over with the blender tool. Right, now just creating the highlighter band that goes over the hair, which you see on a lot of traditional anime. And just repairing a little bit of damage here and there, done by the general painting. Very quickly finding my logos a little too in the face, in those areas. Clearing up my swatches. Thought it'd be nice to try and find a nice rough background. Just to pop her out a little bit.
I'm just rubbing out where I've gone over the highlight.
And then redo my logo again.
My signature.
There we are. That's the finished picture. It's even with the dodgy lines, you can see that the colour really does make it pop out much better. And I am much better at doing colour than I am doing lines. But at least I know where to focus on and to improve myself. Hi guys, if you liked my video, please like, comment and subscribe. And stay tuned for more content.